So welcome, everyone. Welcome to our 50th anniversary birthday party. I think we have over 500 people here tonight. And I was harder to get a ticket to this event than it was to get a ticket to Hamilton. So if you're here tonight, we're really good because there's a lot of people waiting outside. In fact, I think StubHub was selling some of the tickets online at increased price. So unfortunately, some people in the audience had to get them off StubHub. So a party like this, really difficult to pull off. And 8 months ago, when the development team and working with our two co-chairs said, we have a great idea. Let's have it in MOHAI. My initial reaction was, nobody from the East Side ever drives across the bridge. They all think that they're going to get their passport, that's so far away. But thankfully, the development team and these two co-chairs were persistent, and here we all are all tonight. And I want to thank those two coaches. We can get them to come on up. Katie Bowling and Cecilia Wong. Thank you all for coming.
No, I just want to thank Grayson, Doris, and Overlake's golden child, Julia. You guys are amazing. Thank you for your help.
And thank you for your attention. And as I said, behind the scenes, we have our development team, Grayson, Doris, Julia, and Christian. Thank you to all of them as well. I should have told you this is a part of the program where we do a lot of clapping, so get ready to, we're going to want to do some people who have around us. Also, all of the volunteers who helped put on this evening, if you could give them a round of applause, please, for your volunteers. I also want to thank any of our sponsors. So there were a bunch of people who sponsored tonight, a variety of different organizations and individuals. So thank you to all of our sponsors. I also want to thank Bob Bristol, an awesome MC. Again, thank you, Bob. And all of the faculty and staff who put on various community building events. So those are events where it's everything from a Gala night. So who here has some kids who are interested in Gala? I think I can raise my hand. My kids certainly are. To a Gala night, to a summer swine fest event at the school's house, to a paella dinner, all those different things. Thank you to all of those faculty and staff. So here we are, 50 years. And when I think about 50 years, I'm sort of reminded of a guy named Sir Isaac Newton. Anybody know who Sir Isaac Newton was? Brian, who's this?
Woo!
That's
Brian!
So, Isaac Newton, being a math person, pretty important, he developed calculus.
Yes.
And what's called Newtonian physics. So pretty important discoveries. And when he was recognized for those discoveries, he said, I am standing on the shoulders of giants. And although I didn't create physics or Newtonian physics or calculus, I do feel like tonight, our 50th anniversary, I am standing on the shoulders of so many giants at this school. So many people who rolled up their sleeves, got busy and supported the school in a variety of ways. I was just talking to somebody graduating in class of 7 years, and he shared with me that one of the classes that he took in eighth grade was plumbing, electrical, and sort of general carpentry work. And he took that class so that they could actually work on the buildings that they were using in the classes. So we are all standing on those shoulders of those same giants. And I think that's pretty incredible that here we are 50 years later, we have the school we have because of all of that work that went on in the past. And then I think about like what we just saw up here. So we saw a group of kids that performed, variety of different songs. I did love American Pie. I actually pulled out my phone and started to like Cameron put off together a great video. And that fits with who the Overlake School is. Way back in the day, there was a guy named Dean Palmer, started the school in 1972, and he used to say to students all the time, stick your neck out. And why did he say that? Because he wanted kids to take a risk. So when I think about our kids tonight, they got up here and performed, and we were sort of listening, nice background music, we put together a video which we watched. They stuck their necks out. They stuck their neck out. And I think about like a 17-year-old, when I was 17 years old, would I want to get up? Actually, forget 17 years old. This whole night I've been thinking about like right now, I gotta get up in front of people and speak. So think about a 17-year-old having to do that. I think if we think about our own sort of trajectory, we probably put like dental surgery. I'll get that instead of having to perform in front of 500 people that are all my parents' friends. So our kids, they came here, they stuck their neck out, and they did that. And that's the kind of school that we've been in 1978 when we asked the alums to take that 8th grade class and to work on the electrical system and plumbing. Because the kids tonight are performing and creating videos. And that's a pretty special place. And that's why we're all here tonight. And we're all by this school, whether we're an alum, a past parent alum, we are a current parent, we are somebody who works at the school, we're all bound together by this special place that's open. And that's proven. So, on the 50th birthday, what I'm going to ask all of us to do is to... Oh, that's it. Oh, no, it's not. I'm going to ask us all to raise a glass. Once now, always now, to Overlake School, 50 years and 50 more years. Cheers to us. Woo! Have a great evening, everybody, and let's come back tomorrow.
Thank you, Matt. So everyone came and told me that I just failed my first teaching effort because I didn't make me be quiet, I just started talking. But that was on purpose, because I didn't memorize what I was going to say, so you didn't catch all the gaps. Anyway, to get this started, the next thing we want to do, just as I was mentioning about opportunity, we've asked a couple of alums to come back and talk about what the Overlake opportunity has meant to them. So we're asking Beth Irwin Randall and Ryan Marriott, both class of 99, to come up and share. And I just tell one story why it's so nice to see Ryan back, is because it always reminds me that when he was president of the ASB, his mom used to bring these delicious rum cakes to the ASB meetings. And I was caught between the glutton that said, damn, these are good. And wait, there's rum in these that are given to the students. Those were great meetings. Anyway, so Ryan and Beth. To go to college and get a major in economics, and after a few different jobs, as you do after college, I ended up working on the Millennium Village projects at Columbia University for the past 7 years. where we work hard to alleviate poverty in Africa through empirical tests across all of Africa. Try and find a way to change the lives of those who have the least. And similarly,
I'm Beth Randall, also class 99 at Overlake. I went on to Whitman College, studied Spanish language and literature, and have been working at a nonprofit here in Seattle called Global Partnerships for 11 years now. We're a nonprofit social investor, and we provide financing to social businesses that are providing goods and services to people living in poverty in Africa and Latin America. So Ryan and I are very honored to be here speaking tonight on behalf of Overlake. It's a little surprising and scary to say that it's nearly 20 years after we graduated. I think we've known each other for 26 years. And as we mentioned, we both have dedicated our professional lives to expanding opportunities for people living in poverty. And we both spend a lot of time thinking about opportunity and how life-altering an opportunity of any kind can be. Ryan and I feel so fortunate to have received a world-class education at Overlake. And for me, that opportunity was made possible due to the financial aid that I received. Not only did Overlake set us on a course for really incredible college educations, but it equipped us with knowledge, skills, and experiences that were really foundational into our development into the people that we've become. Overlake instilled in us an incredibly strong sense of community, but also responsibility to care for that community and give back, whether it's local or global.
Beth and I have both felt drawn to serve our communities, and we both believe that's because of the time we spent in Overlake, at least in large part. Because, as I'm sure most alums in this room will know, and most parents have heard, these values that Overlake talks about, like respect and compassion and community, are something that the faculty and staff of the school feel at a fundamental level, not just because it's the school's mission, but because that's who they are as well. And while we've been given just a couple minutes to describe all the ways that Overlake changed our life and made us who we are today, we can't do that, but we can hit a couple high points. And of course, Beth mentioned our academic preparation, and the thing that every Overlake student at least comes back and says about the academic preparation is, well, I'm the best writer I know, outside of my other classmates who are all better writers than I am. And that is directly responsible for my success, whatever I have, after leaving Overlake, academically, or professionally, or even personally. Something so simple as being able to argue a coherent point quickly, succinctly, and then communicate that in proper grammar. Something that we take for granted, perhaps. But Overlake really, for us, wasn't about the classroom. It was about the classroom. Why else were we there? But it wasn't just about being in the classroom. It was about being in the community with the faculty, the staff, students, classmates, parents of the people we went to school with. And whether that was bonding through things like the green and gold games of middle school.
Or gold.
Gold may have won on a technicality. You're looking at two captains in eighth grade. It was also about things like Project Week, or communally suffering through yet another annual research project, or an impossibly hard test in AP's MS AP history class, or a theater production with Sarah and Aaron, or late night basketball in the gym, soccer down in the fields in the rain, or Project Week, which I mentioned, Community Service Day, Field Day, Earth Day, retreats, whatever it was a way to break the community down into smaller cross sections and bond and learn how to be together as a larger body of people. It was also about compassion, and it's kind of funny, but 26 years later, since sixth grade morning announcements, I still hear in the back of my head David Bennett's voice, echoing some of Dean Palmer, it turns out, telling us every day in his community service announcements to be a giraffe, stick your neck out, and even ask us to ask ourselves, how could we make the world a better place? I hear that voice in my head. I would never guess it in sixth grade, but I do today, all the time. Beth and I have had the privilege of working with some of the least fortunate people on the entire planet. And while that's made us both acutely aware of how fortunate we are, it's also underscored for us the importance of education, a good education. We have seen the actual trickle-down effect that good education has on a community, as those educators people go forth and change the lives of others that they live with. Tonight, this community has gathered to raise the cattle for a similar and very important cause. To provide this first-class education, this experience that we're celebrating tonight, 50 years of, to those who might not otherwise have access to it. Financial aid expands the reach of Overlake to those who don't have access, and that diversifies the Overlake community, and that enriches the Overlake community. You know, yeah, that's how I feel. It's really important.
So in a couple of moments, you all will see a video that underscores the power of financial aid in the lives of Overlake students while they attend the school, but most importantly, as Ryan has mentioned, the impact that those students then go on to have in the lives of others in their community. The work that Ryan and I have done has been thanks in large part to the generosity of donors who understand the importance of compassion and community. So tonight, we'll be honoring Bill and Anna Armstrong, whose family has been a part of Overlake almost since its founding, and who have long been advocates for financial aid. We hope, Ryan and I hope very sincerely, that you will feel moved as we do to support this important cause. Thank you.
Thank you.